Want to make your design stand out effortlessly? Let me show you how you can remove and customize the background using Adobe Express, the quick and easy create anything app. Honestly, you're gonna wonder how you've ever designed without using this. First of all, let's take a look at the background removal tool. We're gonna select our image and then we're gonna click up here and we're gonna click on remove the background. It's gonna take a few moments just to remove that background, but it does a really good job. If you do decide that you want to add any parts back in, or there's little parts that you want to remove, you can come to this erase option here, and that's going to allow you to either erase further amounts and you can come in and brush those on, or you can click on restore. So if I wanted to restore the table, let's say I wanted to do that, you can see that adds in that really easily. We can add in these bits here, and we can also choose to erase these little bits at the side if we wanted to. Okay, so we've got a ways of doing that. Also click on the circle brush and you can either erase or restore using the circle brush. So that's how you can edit the background removal option. Now, if all you want to do is to remove the background of your image, you're pretty much done. All you have to do is select the background, come to the background color, and then set this to no fill. That's gonna then give you a no fill background. You can then come to the download options and download this as a PNG, and that's it, you're done. However, we wanna customize our background, so let's take a look at customizing the background. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna add in there an additional copy of that image. Okay, so now what we're gonna want to do is actually just edit this and put this in the background, but we're gonna want to make them the same size. And if we want to put the other ones on top, you can come over to the panel at the side and you can just drag these around so you can see which one's on top. Okay, so we've got the background in the background. And what we're gonna do is actually drop the opacity of that so we can try and match that up the best we can. So now we've got those two lined up, we want to add those effects to the background. The first one I'm going to show you is how to blur the background. So we're going to select the background. You can either select that from the canvas or you can select it in your layers panel. And then we're going to come down to adjustments to that. As we add that adjustment on there, we're going to add that more and more blur. You can make that background blurry and it makes you pop from the background. So now we've got that nice buttery smooth blurry background, but we want to make you pop a little bit more. Let's add some saturation. We're going to come over to the adjustments layer one more time and we're going to add in there a little bit of saturation, maybe add a little bit of warmth in there, not too much, and that adds to an effect that you might want to add as a profile picture. The next thing I want to show you is using the duotone effect on the background. So we're going to select the background again, we're going to come over to the effects panel. Now I really like this because you can either go for a grayscale making you pop from the background there, or you could just go for something that's your brand colors. So it's a great way of adding in your brand colors. I really like this version. Now the final option, and this is probably one of my favorite options, and that is to create the pop-out effect. And the way we do that is also by using these different layers. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna actually duplicate the layer of us being popped out here. Okay, so we're gonna have this. Okay, I'm gonna put that to one side a second. Just put me up there. Now what we're gonna want to do is come in and crop me into a circle. So we can see it's really faint here, but we can crop me into a circle. Now what we want to do is actually have me popping out of the circle. So we want my head to kind of like pop out a little bit. So I'm going to reduce the size of this circle and move me around in the circle. Okay, now we've got that there. You can see I'm inside this circle, but the top part of my head is missing. Okay, and we're going to come over and we're going to click on the elements and we want a basic circle shape. Okay, I'm going to go with this one here, which has got two colors to it. I'm going to choose a bright color. So now we're going to want to match these up to the circle. Okay, and now we're going to bring that down to below the area where we're popped out of. Okay, so we can see this, and bear with me, this is going to make perfect sense. We now need to bring in our other image and we want to put this on top. Grab this and we're going to then make us pop out, and now we're going to want to adjust the size to make it match the image below. Take a little bit of backwards and forwards. You might want to zoom in there. Okay, there we go. And that's how we create the pop-out effect using the layers panel inside of Adobe Express. You can then select all of your layers and make these bigger if you want to fit your page. I think you'll agree that's a really cool effect for a profile picture or something like that. Makes you really stand out, makes you pop. So there we go. We've got our different effects that we've created using the background remover tool inside of Adobe Express. We've got the one with no background, and we showed you how to remove the background on that one. And then we've got the one where we've got the blurry background, the one where we used the duotone background, and then my personal favourite, the pop-out effect. Transform your designs, whether it's thumbnails, social media posts, creative effects, or anything else like that. Adobe Express makes it really easy. Try it free today.